Seems to be getting better and better. I hope that all of you had a chance to praise along with us. Missing just a couple of people, maybe one. Alright, so let's start. Last week, I said that I informed you that we're going to be talking about repentance. Repentance is really important because without repentance, you cannot maintain your personal relationship with God, with Jesus Christ, because that's the reason why Jesus Christ came, right? Now, but repentance is a very big word. But it's a word that all of you, whether you're a senior in high school or sixth grader, it's a word that you all must learn. So, maybe some of you already know what repentance means. Can somebody raise your hand or have a hand up sign on you? If you know what repentance means, so basically, repentance, the basic understanding of repentance is this. Realizing that you are a sinner. Repentance basically means first, I realize I'm a sinner and I need forgiveness. Basically, if you don't know that, then you cannot repent because you don't think you need repentance. First thing, you realize that you're a sinner. Second thing, because you realize it, you're sorry. You can't say, I'm a sinner, but I'm not really sorry. You have to realize and you have to be sorry for your sins. And then third is asking God for forgiveness. And number four is coming back to God. So that's basically what repentance is. So So before we can correctly understand what repentance is, we have to first have a correct understanding of what sin is. How many of you know what sin is? Alright, thank you for your hand. I know. So, the title of the message today is What is Sin? Okay? What is Sin? It's a very simple title. So let's read. The scripture today is John. It's the fourth book of the New Testament. John chapter 3. It's the most well-known verse. John chapter 3 verses 16 through 21. Okay, let's every one of you get your Bibles open. If you don't have one open, listen to me very carefully, okay? So we're going to read from John chapter 3, verses 16 through 21. For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, that whoever believes in him, let's all read it together in here, should not perish but have eternal life. For God did not send the Son into the world to condemn the world, but in order that the world might be saved through him. Whoever believes in him is not condemned, but whoever does not believe is condemned already, because he has not believed in the name of the only Son of God. And this is the judgment. The light has come into the world, and people love the darkness rather than the light, because their works were evil. For everyone who does wicked things hates the light and does not come to the light, lest his works should be exposed. But whoever does what is true comes to the light, so that it may be clearly seen that his works have been carried out in God. Amen. Amen. So, when I say the word sin, what comes to your mind? What comes to your mind? What is your understanding of what sin is? How do you define sin? Well, I can tell you from my experience. experience that understanding what sin means depends on your spiritual maturity. Now, when I was really young, when I was a spiritual infant, it doesn't have any to do with age. When I was a spiritually really, really a baby, I understood sin to be doing something bad, something really bad. I identified sin with crime, murder, robbery, stealing, something against the law. And so I didn't consider myself a sinner because I said, hey, I don't do these things. I'm a good boy, basically. And then as I started